praying, please let us continue all the prayer requests that have been submitted before the body. Continue to pray for Sister Virginia, amen, and Brother Clarence. Are there any other unspoken prayer requests? You can make them known by raising up your hand. Let us all bow our heads in prayer. Lord, Heavenly Father, in the precious name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for blessing us all together in this place of worship just one more time. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the word that we heard on this morning, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the word that we're about to receive on this evening, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for all your wonderful blessings that you have restored from our lives for the water blessings in your precious name and the infant of the Holy Ghost. And Lord, we ask, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for your presence that we feel right now in the sanctuary. Lord, we ask, Lord, you prepare our hearts to receive your word, Lord, and let your word fall from good ground and take root in our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
My God. Thank you.
time we'd like for the ushers to come to receive this evening's, praise the Lord, our gifts. We'd like the ushers to come to receive this evening's tithes and offerings. While we're preparing our hearts to give, please let us remember our Sheaves for Christ offering, amen, which is a national fundraising drive, and the money goes to mission, foreign missionaries to provide washers and dryers. It also goes to the Tupelo Children's Home, amen. It's an orphanage for children, amen. And also it's money that is used to support starting local churches, amen. The New Birth Tabernacle started out. The Lord blessed us to receive funding from Sheaves to Christ. So let us all please remember that this, when we give this evening, please remember Sheaves for Christ. Amen? Amen. And also, please let us not forget, coming up on the 12th of September will be our church's groundbreaking service. Amen. And also, Tuesday will be our monthly prayer and fasting day. Ms. Allen, please bless the offering.
Bless me. out of the boat, that's when you're forced to trust God. Without stepping out, there's not really a lot of trust there.
Well,
but as soon as you step out, where's Jesus?
Yeah. Amen. Praise God. Somebody else.
Which is the word of God, which is the truth that you know. You know, I thank God for the I really thank the Lord for the Sunday school lesson and how Alvin brought it out, how they saw how a lot of times scientists or people with, not all scientists, but some people with certain people seek to try to discredit the scriptures. But it seemed like the more that they did, the more they found out they confirmed scripture. You know what I'm saying? So I like to thank the Lord for that. Because I remember when I found out that light came first, and the Bible says the light, I realized that the word of God was true and will always be true. Y'all pray much for my brother.
Hallelujah. Thank you for the holy people. Hallelujah.
People come and people go. have the verse of scripture. Now, the first King, chapter 17, verse 1.
First book of the Kings, chapter 17, verse 1, King James Version. And Elijah the Tishbite, who was of the inhabitants of Gilgad, said unto Ahab, as the Lord God of Israel live, before whom I stand, there shall not be dew nor rain these years, but according to my word. And the Lord has a blessing to the reading and hearing of his word.
Let's pray. Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
we thank you for truth. Bless your people here tonight. Give us a word. We bless your holy name. Will you clap your hands unto the Lord?
Amen.
Israel, wicked king, with a message that would seem to disrupt life throughout the entire region.
Yeah.
He had a word for the Lord, folks. And that word shook the entire region. The Lord had told sometimes we will sit in a service and the man of God is trying to tell us something to help us.
Yes.
But the man of God that steps behind this podium, he steps behind this podium with authority.
Yes.
It comes from God.
Yes.
The valid, dated, the valid message that he had, it was revealed to him. His source was God. And when we think in terms of sometimes an individual, that's a mouthpiece. Man of God to step behind the pulpit is not just a mouthpiece.
Come on, preacher.
It's times that God wants to reveal some things to us.
Uh-huh.
If we have attentive ears and then simply listen and open our minds to the word of God, the Lord wants to help us.
Amen.
You see, there was a problem. Amen. Israel was considered to be a backslidden nation because of this wicked king.
Yes.
And the Lord, amen, loved Israel. He was concerned. And when God is concerned about a people, he always raised up a prophet.
Yes, uh-huh.
Amen. Uh-huh. Amen. Yeah. Elijah was a man of great faith. Amen. Who believed what God told him. He could only speak with authority. I don't want to get behind this pulpit anytime if I don't have the Lord's backing.
Amen.
You clap your hands unto the Lord, hallelujah. Because he knew and trusted the one who gave the message. You see, he was just an ordinary man. But he spent time alone with the Lord, and the Lord decided to give him a message.
Yes.
To wake up the people. And at times, amen, behind this pulpit, the Lord is trying to wake you up.
Yes.
I'm not just getting up here just talking.
Yeah.
I got a message from the Lord. He spent time alone with the Lord and listened as he stood before him.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
There are times in your walk with God, you don't have to be a minister,
come on.
But you need to spend time alone.
Yes,
uh-huh.
Time alone with God. And allow the Lord to speak to you. Because he has a message for every individual in this house tonight.
Yes.
If you just decide to spend some time alone with the Lord.
Right.
The reason why the Lord could give him this message. He was consecrated. He trusted God. And he spent time alone with the Lord. Prayerlessness is sin.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Much prayer, much power.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
So vital when I walk with God to spend time alone with the Lord. We get so busy on our jobs, getting involved with things at home.
Yes.
Not taking time out, amen, to pray.
Yes.
So vital when I walk with God, if God wants, amen, to speak to us, he won't speak to us when we are alone with him. of God doesn't speak exactly the same matter that he spoke to the Old Testament prophets. But the process of receiving his message hasn't changed. Reason why we like to pray before service. We want you to spend time alone with the Lord, because the Lord has a message. He has an individual message tailored to every individual in the house. And sometimes that message, amen, it involves something that you are involved in. And the Lord's trying to help you.
Yes, thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, thank you.
You see, it begins with being alone in his presence. It involves listening. And he speaks through his word. But it shouldn't end there. It shouldn't end there. You need to come to the house of God with a mind open to receive the message that God has for you. Will you clap your hands up to the Lord? Oh, yes. You see, the messenger had responsibilities. The prophet had responsibilities of telling the people what the Lord revealed to him. The man of God has a responsibility to reveal to you what the Lord has simply revealed to you.
That's right, preacher. That's right.
That's right.
Praise God.
Yeah.
You know, we are called out of darkness into his marvelous light, and when we hear a message, we are to share it with others. What we learned from the word. Let me tell you something. Living for God is like lifting weights. If you don't exercise what you receive, you hear the word of God, you take it, and you apply it to your life. You want to build some muscles up? Start a program of lifting weights. You want to mature in God? Start a reading program of reading your Bible. I'm going to be very honest with you. You need to take time out by a Sunday school book.
Say it again, Pastor. That's right.
Hello? Everybody needs a Sunday school book. I don't care how old you are.
Go ahead, preacher.
And you need to look in that Sunday school book and spend some time alone and allow the Lord to talk to you. Devotional time with the Lord is just not about our own interests in God. Let me say it again. Devotion time is not just for you. Devotional time is for your family. Your co-worker. Your friends. Don't worry about it. If you spend correctly your devotional time, you ain't going to have to worry about your knees, because God's going to take care of your knees. Will you clap your hands into the Lord? Spend some time. Our Heavenly Father reveals his treasures to us so that we could share them with others. One of the greatest treasures that he has shared with us, giving us a revelation of who God is. Mm-hmm. And what it takes to get saved.
Uh-huh.
Repent.
Uh-huh.
And be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sin. That's a treasure, folks.
That's a treasure.
Yes, it is.
That's a treasure.
Yeah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
That's a treasure. Yeah. That he has given to you. And he wants you to share that treasure with somebody else. Will you clap your hand unto the Lord?
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
I wish we could get a revelation, an understanding how important it is to share the word which we receive with somebody else.
Yes, yes.
Mention some time back how important it is this. Get on your Facebook page and share the preaching. Hello. Hello. Share the preaching. Some of us have heard it. It went from one ear out to another.
Well, right.
And all it takes for you to pull up and like that. You sit at the church service and receive. And God is commanding us to share with others. We clap your hands unto the Lord. Thank you. This prophet, it appeared that because he spent so much time alone with the Lord spoke to him. Read on, brother.
And the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, get thee hence, and turn thee eastward, and hide thyself by the brook Cherith, that is by before Jordan. And it shall be that thou shalt drink of the brook. And I have commanded the ravens to feed thee there. So he went and did according unto the word.
Notice that. He went.
Uh-huh.
And done according
to the word. Come on.
To the word of the Lord.
Hello. You're going to miss out on your blessing.
Well.
When God called you to do something and you refuse to do it.
Well.
Read on, brother.
He went
exactly where the Lord wanted him to go.
That's right, preacher.
Read on.
That is before Jordan.
Uh-huh.
And the ravens brought him bread.
Uh-huh.
And the ravens.
Uh-huh.
Didn't he bring him bread and meat?
Yes, sir.
Bought him a sandwich. That's right, preacher.
Yes.
Huh? Simply because he obeyed the Lord.
Go ahead and preach.
His ears were open.
Yes, right.
Some of us need to open our ears and listen. Especially when you come to an apostolic service. You need to listen. And what you receive, you need to share it. If you want to build your muscles up. Read on, brother. Giving us messages. And we have a tendency not to obey them. Read on, brother.
Behold, I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee.
And the Lord went before him and talked to a widow woman. Yeah. Read on.
So he arose and went to Zarephath, and when he came to the gate of the city, behold, the widow woman was there gathering of sticks. And he called to her and said, fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel.
My. Let me tell you something. She obeyed the message.
The message. That's right. She obeyed the prophet.
Obey the prophet, and you will prosper.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah. But make me thereof a little cake first.
A little cake.
And bring it unto me, and after make the leaf.
You got to think of the atmosphere. Times were tough.
Times were hard.
But the Lord took care of the prophet.
Uh-huh.
And when their times are tough,
uh-huh,
if you obey the Lord,
uh-huh,
he'll do the same thing for you. He will take care of you. Would you clap your hands up to the Lord? He will take care of you. Read on. Examples in the Word of God over and over again how God will take care of you when you're going through.
Amen.
If you simply spend time alone and obey the messenger.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. You share treasures out of the Word of the Lord. Let's begin each day along with God in His Word and in prayer and listen as He speaks to your heart.
Yes.
We'll get on our face and be there 1 minute.
Yeah.
And we up and going.
Yeah.
Probably sitting on top. I said, won't you hold up, I got something to say.
Amen.
Hello? Set aside some time. Simply be alone with the Lord. This being too busy not to be alone with the Lord. It's damaging to your walk with God. The best time that you ever can actually have is not simply clapping your hands and running the house and jumping up and down. But the best time that you can ever have is time alone in the presence of the Lord.
That's right.
Would you clap your hands on the Lord? Time alone in the presence of the Lord. Simply believe what he says in the scripture. Apply it to your life and then share it with someone else what he has simply revealed to you. There were some things shared in Sunday school. You ought to bring a little notebook to Sunday school.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. Yes, that's right.
Hello?
Right.
Yeah. God doesn't give you a message for you just to go home and sit down on it. He's giving you a word to share it with somebody else. I don't care if you just share it with your dog.
Go ahead.
But share it. But share it. Share it. It's so vital in our walk with God. And we're going to mature in God. We got to take the message and share it. You see in the Word of God how Elijah had spent time alone. Over and over and over, God spoke to him. And he spoke to him, and there were great challenges before him. Hello?
Yes.
He didn't hesitate. Hello?
Yes.
He just went and did it, didn't he? And because he simply went and done it, he got to see the supernatural.
Uh-huh.
You want to see miracles? I guarantee you, if you start spending some time alone and start sharing the word of God with a family member, co-worker, friend, you'll see some of them get the Holy Ghost and get baptized in Jesus' name. Will you clap your hands unto the Lord? Hallelujah. Be bold.
Yeah.
Be bold.
Uh-huh.
And remember that the authority of the message comes from God.
Amen.
Years ago, I was in a place called Darmstadt, Germany. The church was named New Birth Tabernacle. That's where I got the Holy Ghost at. Got baptized. And every Saturday, there was a group of saints that went to the Fiat with their Bibles. And they opened it to Acts 2:38. And everybody they came in contact with, they shared Acts 2:38. You know what happened? There were so many people that came to God simply because they decided to go out and share the word of God. We give out leaflets. business or what have you. But I'm challenging you tonight. Get your Bible the next time you're going out preaching. Flip to Acts 2:38 and share it with people that you come in contact with. Let's share it. Praise God. God has given us an authority. We need to be bold.
Yes.
Not timid, but we need to be bold. And that's how we're going to turn this city upside down. We got to start being bold and declaring the message. Would you stay in this living right now? Because the attitude of that church was sharing the message, I got saved. And I never met one of them outside the pigs, but he read Acts 2:38. But God sent another man with a message.
Right.
He shared the treasure that he had with me. And you need to make up in your mind to share your treasure that he gave you with somebody else. That's how revival will come. That we wake up and share the treasure. It's a treasure, folks. You put up your sin, got the Holy Ghost talking tongue. Living the Holy Ghost. Hey, man, this is the best thing going.
Right.
Yes.
Praise God. Delivering from alcohol, drugs.
Yes.
Hmm?
Yes. Amen.
Kept you from alcohol, drugs, from the time you were born.
Yes. Man,
you got a treasure.
Oh, yes.
Praise God. I wish I had a testimony that I never spoke to you. Go for
it. Well, amen. You got that right.
But you know what? Your testimony is more powerful than mine.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
All right now.
Because you never test.
That's right.
Will you clap your hands unto the Lord? Thank you. We're in the process of milestone. Start the new facility. And the only way we're going to fill it up, we got to get bold.
Yes, yes.
We got to get bold. We got to step out of the boat.
Yes.
Elijah did not know exactly how God was going to help him. But he was encouraged by the word, and he decided to obey the word, and God filled everything in, took care of everything.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
And that's what the Lord wants us to do.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Obey the message.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
And God will take care of whatever you need.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God. This is not the time to be in the comfort zone.
Uh-huh.
Right.
The Lord spoke to me some years ago. Come to Dawson. He was the authority behind the message. Had no idea how everything was going to turn out.
Uh-huh.
But I simply stepped out of the boat. Didn't have nothing to hold on. Only had the Lord turned to.
Yes.
Simply because I obeyed the message that he spoke to me alone. We got a church here. And then when people touch all over the country, even overseas,
yes,
praise God, simply because this old fella decided to obey the message.
Amen.
That's how you're going to have greater revival. God wants us to share our treasure with somebody else. This is a treasure. How many folks around here want God to baptize you with boldness to share the message? Won't you come down here and gather around this altar if you want the Lord, amen, to give you boldness right now? I believe the Lord can anoint you tonight with boldness to get out there. And if you don't start, immediately you're going to lose it. Let's talk to the Lord. Lord, touch me with a fresh anointing. A fresh anointing where I'll be bold in sharing my treasure that you bless me with, Lord. Come on, hallelujah. Anoint me with boldness right now. Come on, somebody pray in the Holy Ghost. Come on, let the Lord anoint you right now. Come on, hallelujah. We're not going to the motion, right? Anoint me, Lord. Anoint me, Lord. Praise God. Praise God. Anoint me, Lord. Anoint me, Lord. First encounter with that minister who came with me, came to me with boldness. I thought, who do you think he is?
Yeah. Amen.
That's my thought. He's going to come up here and bring you a message. Thank God. Kept coming back.
Yes.
Sharing his treasure. And finally, I decided to embrace his treasure. God is looking for messengers.
Yes.
He called me out of darkness to his mom's side. You don't have a pulpit in ministry, but you have a message. Share with everyone. Will you clap your hands and Lord, thank you.